50 gram
yeah.
equal to 100. Can give.
100 gram only 40,000.
No.
Why?
No, 100
now,
gram for 100.
Least,
I'll take.
250 gram, how much?
100.
No, 100 gram.
No, 100 no, make less. Make less, we both take.
Hey guys, welcome to this video coming to you from the Ben Thanh market in Ho Chi Minh City. In this video, you're going to get all the information about Ben Thanh, right from how to reach, what are the must buys in the market, what is the correct price to pay. We also have some bargaining tips for you, and of course, what to eat and drink when you're tired of all the shopping. So let's get started.
So I'm currently in Ho Chi Minh and this is my day one. Post lunch, now we are going to the Ben Thanh market. Now, Ben Thanh market is one of the largest markets in Vietnam. It's an indoor market. And I have read that you can practically buy anything and everything in this market, right from clothes, to electronics, to handicraft and souvenirs. Now the Ben Thanh market is in District 1 of Ho Chi Minh. So it's pretty easily accessible. We took a cab. And if you live in District 1, you can actually even just walk to the market. So giving me company today afternoon is Abhi. Kya plan hai shopping ka? What do you plan to shop?
Clothes.
So we are going to look for clothes. And in fact, after 7 p.m, there's a night market which opens just outside the indoor market. And we plan to check out that as well.
So when you enter the market, you'll see rows and rows and rows of shops stuck together. There are literally thousands of shops. My suggestion is to not get overwhelmed and don't overthink. Just start from one side of the market and start exploring. For me, this market was literally like a human museum where one could dive deep into the sound, smell and colors of the Vietnamese culture. We started at the side of the market which had all the food.
So one side of the market just has food and that's where we are walking right now. So there are a lot of fresh fruits and there are also coffee shops. So if you want to buy Vietnamese coffee, you can come here. And I can see tons and tons of snacks. So this market has a lot of such narrow lanes and you can just pick any lane and keep walking.
The first shop that we walked into was an authentic Vietnamese coffee shop.
This is the squirrel coffee.
Yeah.
Legendary.
Yeah.
Arabica.
We saw. Luwa
One. Oh my god.
Oh. Not even heard the name.
So this is what squirrel coffee? Oh, okay. This is the filter. Basically, you put the coffee here. Pour hot water and then it drips, the decoction drips down from
there. Hello,
if you're here, you have to bargain and this is how you do it.
250 gram.
Please watch and learn.
250 gram
yeah.
equal to 100. Can give.
100 gram only 40,000.
No.
Why?
No, 100 gram for 100.
I'll take.
250 gram, how much?
100.
No, make less,
we both take.
No.
Yeah.
Why?
She also takes.
She. 180,000.
Where are you from?
Belgium.
Okay. She also take. You make 100, we three take.
Initial price which the lady told us was 300 Vietnamese dong for 250 gram, and guess what, we ended up paying just 100 Vietnamese dong for the 250 gram, and of course we got a free filter to go with it. The next thing that you must try in Ben Thanh are the cashew nuts. They are very good quality and they make for such a good gift to take back to your family. I in fact picked up a bag for my mother and she was so happy with it.
One tip that I have for you guys to shop here is to not to come on weekends. So avoid coming here on Friday, Saturday, Sunday because it will get extremely crowded. Try to come here on a weekday and also try to come around afternoon. That's between 3 o'clock to 4 o'clock where it's not very crowded. because I'm told that in the morning, daytime, the place can get pretty crowded. So if you want to avoid the peak time rush, try and come here between 3 and 4 in the afternoon. So one side of the market basically had all fruits and dry fruits, and the other side of the market, which is behind me, has a lot of stalls. So here, if you want to eat food, then there are a lot of these tiny stalls which are selling noodles, spring rolls, and I can also see a lot of coffee shops. So if you want to take a break from shopping and walking around, you can come here and grab something to eat. Drawback of this market is the heat. And yeah, so we are just having some coconut water to cool ourselves off.
Next to the food stalls are the home decor and the handicraft stores. These stores are very, very pretty, and they are good if you want to pick up teacups, which are made up of porcelain, if you want to pick up some crockery, or if you're just looking for some funky home decor.
What is this? Just a SI kuch time. Yes. Matlab kuch saman
made of buffalo horn.
Yeah, it's not plastic. She burnt it and she saw it.
Okay.
She told me for 650 and I took it for 300.
What did you buy?
Taking three trays.
Okay.
No.
Nice. Very pretty.
The outer perimeter of the market has all the government-owned shops. These are fixed-price shops, and you can recognize them by a blue sign that will be hanging on the top.
Now, if you're shopping in the Bintan market, haggling and bargaining becomes a must. If you totally want to avoid that, you can come to the outer perimeter of the market. That's where I am. And these are the shops where you will see the ones with the blue sign, which are fixed-price shops. So these are government-controlled shops, and all these are fixed-price shops. So the prices might be a little higher compared to the stores inside, but you can completely avoid bargaining and haggling.
After wandering around the market for quite some time, we finally found the clothes section. This, by the way, is opposite to the food shops. So one end of the market has the food shops and the other end has the clothes shops. And in these clothes stores, you will see a lot of knockoffs of the branded stuff, but they are of such good quality that it's worth picking up. And of course, you will have to bargain to bring the prices down.
10, 170. You say 210, I say 170. I take 3 piece.
Okay.
I take 5 piece more discount.
So after a very, very, very long bargaining session, we picked up some sportswear, but I think we got good prizes for it. So guys, remember to bargain.
The fabric stores are a must visit in Ben Thanh. You get such beautiful prints and they're of extremely high quality.
So guys, that was the tour of the Ben Thanh market. We spent, I think, about 3 to 4 hours. I would suggest that go there if you have sufficient time, and also if you're willing to bargain, because the prices are inflated and you really have to work hard to bring it down.
So we picked up 2 basic clothes, some fresh coffee, and Aditi also picked up some home decor stuff. So overall, I think it's good to go with an open mind just to have fun and also to get a glimpse of the Vietnamese culture. But if you want some serious shopping, then I don't know, I think you have to have a lot of patience to really dig through the stuff and find something. One thing which we found very interesting was the fabric market. They're very good fabrics, though that requires again a lot of time, and we were already very, very tired. So we'll probably come back another day. And one thing which we missed buying were the souvenirs.
Yeah.
So
maybe night market.
Yeah. So next, now is that we are going to go get some coffee because we are dead.
Cold coffee.
And we'll come back for the night market. So the night market is just outside the Bintan market. So I think it makes sense to do both of it the same day. And yeah, I'll show you the night market. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. My name is Shachi. I make new videos every week. Don't forget to hit the subscribe and the bell button so that you are notified of my next travel video. And I'll see you very soon. So guys, that was the tour of the Bintan market.